What's the worst thing you've ever been accused of while being completely innocent?
Drugs.
Shockingly enough, my parents' divorce made me act out at 9 years old, and I kept distracting other kids in class. My mom was convinced it was because I was doing drugs and yanked hair out of my head and made me get blood tested. They found nothing, because I was 9 years old. I helped a friend of my mother move when I had just turned 18 for no pay. And this lady accused me of stealing one of her guns. I booked it straight to the police department to explain the situation. When she tried to report me, they told her she was crazy. They already spoke to me. And that criminals that steal guns don't go directly to the police. I was accused of destroying a window at school by dropping a rock from a higher floor. Interrogated by the principal, parents were called. Friends had to fund the repairs. Bullied on the bus. It sucked. Found out who it was 2 years later. But by then nobody cared. This is tame compared to others in this thread, but it's one that has stuck with me for ages. When I was really little, around 6, my aunt was babysitting me. My sweet dog was shedding fur. My aunt accused me of cutting her fur. She had me across her knee saying she wouldn't spank me if I admitted it. I was sobbing uncontrollably because I loved my dog. We were the same age and she was like a second mom and would never do that to her. My mom came home not long after and I do remember her being livid. Despite my issues with my mom, she never once laid a hand on me. My mom couldn't believe that her sister never comprehended that animal sheds fur in clumps. In third grade, one walked to a convenience store with $2 and spent 20 minutes trying to decide what candy to get, picking things up and putting them back. The old lady clerk accused me of stealing and said to never come back. That was a bit problematic given it was the only gas station in my small town. And I've moved back and been living here for the last 15 years. I was 14 and had just started to learn how to use a digital camera. The only one I had at the time was my mom's. Sometime after my birthday, the SD card that was my mom's went missing. My dad immediately went to blame me for it and my mom was hoping I didn't do it. After over an hour of interrogating me, we still couldn't find it. Come to find out, my mom had put it in her normal place of valuables she keeps it in. I didn't even get an apology edit. Spelling. We lived in a townhome condo complex. My mom was fighting with the board over misused funds. When she was at work, there was a knock at our door. One of the neighbors had an emergency and asked if I could come and watch her kids while she went to the hospital. Sure. I was 16 and had been babysitting for 4 years. I spent a few hours looking after two cute kids, 3 and 5. I got home before my mom. We started dinner and there was a knock at the door. It was a pair of police. The mother had gone to the police station and accused me of abusing her 3-year-old. She said that I hit her and locked her in the dryer for several hours. My mom asked the cop if he was insane. She pointed out that I was the kid who picked caterpillars off the walk and put them on the grass so people didn't step on them. She asked the cops to point out the complainant. When he pointed, my mom asked me if I was crazy because that's the woman who stole funds from the condo board. Why would I go there? I said I didn't know that, and that she said she had to go to the hospital immediately because her dad had had a heart attack. The cops said they would be back. They came back an hour later and said I would not need to come with them after all. Turns out dad was alive and well. I wasn't so well after having a full-blown panic attack for an hour. Drugs. When I was in high school, I had a very monotonous voice that my parents thought was fake, and anytime we were out they would ask someone to tell me what I sound like because they thought that if I was embarrassed enough I would talk normally. Instead it made me talk less and me shut out some of my friends in my life. When they realized I wasn't talking, they jumped to conclusions and accused me of doing drugs. What really made them think I was doing drugs was when I lost $20 at my school's picnic. They were constantly counting my money to see if they can prove I was doing drugs and realized that I was missing $40 and told me to tell them what happened to it. I explained to them that I had a picnic at school and brought $40 with me but lost half of it. They said my story didn't add up, so they started to rummage through my backpack and room anytime I wasn't at home and would ask for the names of my friends and anyone that I was talking to so that they could run background checks on them. Posted this before, but seems relevant. I was fighting with my brother. Realized the fight was dumb, so I just went to my room. My brother decided to punch himself and blame me. My mom is yelling at me and grounding me. I can't believe you did that to your brother. Blah blah blah. So I figured if I was about to get in trouble for it, I should actually do it. I turn around and actually clocked my brother in the face, to which he responded, I can't believe she actually did that, and my mom realized he had been lying. I ended up not getting in trouble. Probably kicking my young son. I was carrying something like hot tea or soup and he went to grab me. So I put my knee out to stop him getting close to me and scalding himself. But for some reason, everyone else in the room thought I kicked him or kneed him. Very strange situation. When I was 11, I was accused by a babysitter that I was molesting my sister when I was really playing my Nintendo DS with her. It was completely unbelievable because she said that she made it all up because she didn't want to change diapers. She got fired by my mom, and the last I saw her, she was living in her car. I know this is ridiculous. But in second grade, another child accused me of calling my teacher A. No one believed me when I claimed innocence. And I got a spanking and was forced to apologize. I felt so powerless because since all the adults believed I was guilty. In effect, I was. I think I'm still a little mad about it. My father was accused of murdering the neighbor's dog and disposing it at a remote beach. When I was a kid, we had a rocky relationship with one of the neighbors because they had a yappy dog that they took very poor care of. It drove the whole street mad, but for some reason it never got taken away by animal control. A few years ago, my parents moved to another part of town. Afterwards, Dad worked on the old house to get it ready to sell. One day he was on the driveway when the neighbors left in their car. They made eye contact. Then, when the neighbors returned, their dog was inexplicably missing. They instantly accused Dad of sneaking over and butchering the dog because he had enough of it. He tried to explain that an animal control van had briefly come through the street shortly after they left. But they weren't having a bar of it. They were so convinced he had done something, they started a massive social media campaign to pressure him into admitting it. Including invading all the local community groups and outing him. They even went so far as to drive an hour out of town to the beach we often go to in the weekends to put up posters. It was wild, stressful, and stupid. It only stopped after we picked up a lawyer and sent a cease and desist letter threatening to take them to court for public defamation. The dog was never found, and apparently they have two new ones now. This was also the same family that found someone's lost cat and decided to keep it. When I was 16, I was riding with a friend back to another friend's house and the cops pulled him over. I had nothing on me. He, unbeknownst to me, threw a bag of coke underneath my chair. Cops found it. Put us both in jail. Took him to county, 17 yo. Took me to juvie, 16 yo. He got out before me and hired a lawyer. Pinned it on me through family connections. Got the charges reduced from a felony to a misdemeanor cause I was a good kid and it showed. Ruined my life for a good 5 years. Just heard that the kid all grown up broke into his ex-GF's house to steal drugs and is pretty much a burnout loser. I'm applying for law school next spring. I was 9 and a Girl Scout. I was attending a Girl Scout camp and the leader accused me of throwing trash around the campsite. She made me sit in a chair in the corner of a building. I remember crying over the whole situation. For the record, I didn't throw trash around the campsite. The leader was a mean woman. A friend who became a friend with benefits called me a lying the first time we had. Followed immediately by, you told me you had a vasectomy. She didn't realize that a vasectomy just takes the seeds out of the orange juice. It doesn't eliminate the orange juice. Had just moved to a new school in 5th grade. Was never great at making new friends. So I thought I'd sugar them up by bringing sugar mixed with Kool-Aid. Something that was popular at my old school. Who doesn't love a bunch of 10-year-olds licking their fingers and dipping them in a baggie of sugar? Apparently, an older kid had given several first graders heroin during this time and it got pegged on me. I was removed from class. Police came. I cried like a because I didn't understand why they thought my grape Kool-Aid was heroin. I kept telling them to taste it. The principal finally did and realized I was telling the truth. Awesome first week of school. Wife and I were asleep in bed. And when we woke up, she rolled over to get out of bed. She hit her eye on the corner of her nightstand and it left a sick bruised, cut black eye for about a week. I had friends asking me if I hit her. And one friend gave me the business saying it's not cool to hit your wife. That friend actually beats his wife.